Good morning.
Good morning, Mr. Miles.
How are you?
I'm doing well.
Good.
Okay, Ms. Clark, you're up again. Status update on the election of the employee representative to the Civil Service Board.
Mr. Chairman, the nominations have been received. The nomination period is closed. The elections began on December the 12th.
Yesterday.
They will run through noon on December the 19th. I will then submit the name of the individual receiving the most votes to the county manager and request that it be considered a time-sensitive item on the January 8th, 2013 work session.
Okay.
And we do, we had originally four nominations. One of those did not meet the qualifications, and then one had requested to be removed from nominations. So we have two. We have Mr. Perry and Charles Lockenhouse.
Okay. Okey-dokey.
Can I interject something, Mr. Chairman?
Yes.
Your next meeting is January 10th. And so if the person is elected, we sincerely hope that the commissioners will take action on January the 8th, which will be 2 days in advance. If they do not, then Mr. Perry, regardless of the election outcome, would serve until his successor is appointed. Just so that we're all clear on it. So,
Okay.
And I appreciate you getting them to expedite the hearing or the consideration of whatever the election result is.
Okay,
item number five, appointment of hearing officer to the Civil Service Board for calendar year 2013. Ms. Clark.
Mr. Chairman, this is just one of those housekeeping items that we need to, you all need to consider your appointment of the hearing officer for calendar year 2013, and then that would go to the Board of Commissioners. I would expect that we would try to put that also on the January 18th, January 8th, 2013 meeting of the Board of Commissioners.
Okay. Gentlemen, we need to elect a hearing officer. Do I hear any nominations?
Mr. Chairman, I make a motion that we elect or appoint or ask to appoint our hearing officer, Mr. Dan Myers.
Okay. Any other considerations? If not, do you put that in the form of a motion?
Mr. Chairman, I make that a motion that we accept Mr. Dan Myers.
Okay. Hear a second?
Second.
We have a motion and a second to appoint Mr. Miles to be our hearing officer for another year.
Excuse me, Mr. Smith. Also, you're required under the rules to request someone to serve as board counsel. In other words, you have a hearing officer that presides over hearings. You also have board counsel that serves as general counsel to the Civil Service Board. And as I read your rules, you're supposed to request both. Typically, that's the same person, and then that's hopefully approved.
We can do that in one motion.
In one motion, but your motion right now is just for hearing officer.
Will you take back your second? You take back your motion. Now will you make another motion that will include both jobs?
I make a motion, Mr. Chairman, that we recommend or elect Ms. Dana Miles as our hearing officer and
general counsel.
General counsel.
Okay. Hear a second?
I'll second.
There's a motion and a second to nominate and appoint Mr. Dana Miles as our hearing officer and our legal counsel for the year 2013. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Motion carries unanimously. And if I might add, as the chairman, it's been a privilege to work with you, and I appreciate all that you've done to help us.
Thank you very much.
You're not only our advisor, but you're also my friend, and I appreciate that.
Those very kind words. Thank you very much.
Mr. Miles, how many years have you been hearing officer? My embarrassment.
At least 12, maybe 13 or 14. It seems like it was 2000. It might have been 98 or 99. I don't recall for sure. At least since 2000.
Time marches on.
Yes, sir, it does.
Yes, sir. Well, we appreciate you very much. You've done a great job for
us.
And what, how we did it before you came on, how do you
know? I'm sure you did fine. Thank you for the compliment.
Okay, item number six, the appointment of our clerk to the Civil Service Board for the calendar year 2013. Ms. Clark, will you be available to serve another year?
Mr. Smith, while it's been an honor to serve as your Civil Service Board clerk for these past few years, In looking at the workload of our department, and as well as looking at how the clerks with the other boards are assigned, I would request that you consider appointing Amber Watson. Amber has been shadowing for some time. She's been with us since July. That you might consider appointing her as clerk so that I can assume other duties within the department.
Okay. You have done an excellent job.
Sure.
I can say that you've done as good a job or better than any clerk we've ever had, and I appreciate it, and we will miss you.
Ms. Watson, you're on the board now.
Do I hear a nomination for Ms. Clark to be our clerk?
Ms. Watson.
Excuse me. Ms. Watson.
I'll make that motion, Mr. Chairman. Okay. We ask Ms. Watson to be our clerk.
Okay.
I'll second.
Motion and a second that Ms. Amber Watson be our clerk for the year 2013. Is there any discussion? If not, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Motion carries unanimously. We welcome you aboard.
Thank you.
Big shoes to fill, Amber.
Feel certain of that.
You'll be an asset to the board.
You will, and I pray that we'll all be kind and gentle and not require too much. So.
I think she'll do a great job. She's been doing a lot of the work, the minutes, and putting together the agendas and the postings for several months now, and I'm very pleased, and I think that she will do a great job for this board, but certainly has been an honor and a privilege to serve you for the last few years. And
yeah. You've done an excellent job. You'll be missed.
Do we have any changes to the agenda today?
I do, Chairman.
Yes, sir.
Start. I'd like the board to consider postponing item number 4, the appointment of Amber Watson as the clerk of the Civil Service Board for calendar year 2013. We would like to postpone that until the January 22nd work session.
Do I hear a motion?
So moved.
Second. I have a motion and second. Everyone please vote by aye. All in favor, aye. All opposed?
Chairman, my next item is for your consideration to add Civil Service Board employee representative appointment. This item will be handled by Charity Clark. I would ask you to consider place this as new item 6. If you consider that.
New item 6?
You want to replace those 4?
You can. If you'd like to do that, that would be fine.
Or what was it? It was.
We're going to put it as 4?
Go 4 is fine.
What was the item?
The item is Civil Service Board Employee Representative Appointment. Charity Clark is going to handle that item. So that would be new item 4.
So moved. Second.
We have a motion and a second to add Civil Service by Charity Clark. All vote by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Carries 5-0.
As changing a figure on the amendment. Won't be hard at all.
Thank you. The original item 4 has been postponed the Amber Watson to January 22nd, and the new item 4, Civil Service and Charity Clark.
Mr. Chairman, may I respectfully, before we get into this, may I respectfully ask for a 5-minute recess?
Yes, sir. 5-minute recess.
Without exception.
I see.
I love recess.
Charity Clark.
Mr. Chairman, Commissioners, this is a request This is a time-sensitive request for the appointment of Tim Perry to serve in the unexpired term that was recently vacated by John Blanchard as the employee representative for the Civil Service Board. There was a nomination period, there was an election, and Mr. Perry received the majority of the civil service employee vote. So per Civil Service Policy 2, Section 2, C2, I request that the Board of Commissioners appoint Mr. Perry as a county employee representative for the Civil Service Board, and his term will run through September 14th, 2015.
Do I hear a motion from the board?
So moved.
Have a motion and a second. All
time sensitive.
Yes, time sensitive.
Time sensitive on my motion.
All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries 5-0. Item 5, the appointment of Dana Miles as hearing officer. Now, I'd like to make a statement before we start that Dana Miles has never been my personal attorney in any fact or motion. We do belong to the same Rotary Club, but it's just a friendly matter.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. This request is for the appointment of Dana Miles as the hearing officer and general counsel for the Civil Service Board for calendar year 2013. Also attached is the Civil Service Board minutes, where at their December 13th meeting, they appointed Mr. Miles as counsel and hearing officer. I also have a letter from the chairman, and also the pricing from Miles, Patterson, Hansford, and Talent, stating that there will be no rate increase for 2013.
Any questions? Is there a motion?
Yes, Mr. Chairman, I move that the appointment of Dana Miles as hearing officer and general counsel for the Civil Service Board for calendar year 2013. I guess that needs to be time sensitive.
Yes. Yes.
Second. Have a motion and a second. All vote, please say an aye. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. All opposed?
Aye.
Motion carries 3-2.
And that will, just for purposes of the record, that will go on the next new business.
Mr. Chairman, Commissioners, this is a request to approve